baby, they can miss me. Lay low, lay low, lay low, lay low. If you think twice, it's already risky. Yo, you miss me, baby, then you miss me.
This is Talk More About It. We here with episode 3. This is Abel, your host. Let's get it. M.O. Boombox. I got two of my hosts right here. I got JO Iyce. Go ahead, JO Iyce.
What up, DJ JO Iyce, 93.9 WKYS, Sway in the Morning, Freeband Gang, you know all that. DMV, yeah. We outside.
Let's go. I got my other man's designer, clothing brand owner, Damar.
Man, you got Damar from Washington, D.C., man. We swagged up on this app.
Yeah, that's cool, cool, cool. So welcome back, guys. We got a really dope episode for y'all. I know it's been a while, but we're going to start off, you know, giving introductions to my guests right here. We'll start off with JO Iyce. JO Iyce, you know, dope DJ. He worked with me at Focus. Probably one of the best DJs in the city for the whole nation, to be honest. So kind of like just give us a background, how you started, you know, how you like DC, your experience here, and, you know, pretty much just the background, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, I started off like doing music first, so I was like rapping when I first started.
You were rapping?
Yeah, I was. Yeah,
that's crazy.
Long story.
When was this?
This was 2002.
Okay.
2002, 2003.
Wait, what was your rap name?
JO Iyce.
Okay, I was about to say.
Yeah. So, I mean, first it was Joker, and then, you know, they started calling me Iyce for whatever reason. Mm-hmm. And then I was like, well, I don't like Iyce, but everybody keep calling me Iyce. Then I was like, you know what? I know how to make it make sense. My grandma's name is Joyce. Boom, I took the Joe from Joker, the Iyce from Iyce, Joyce, boom,
that's
bow. Now it got
that.
A meaning to it, so it's not just like, you know, because JO Iyce, my name is not Joe, like, you know what I'm saying? So everybody thinks my
say,
name
that's
is
not
Joe.
Your real name, man.
Nah, so.
Wait, because I'm not gonna lie to you, the one thing is every time I be trying to search you, I put J-O-E and then space I.
Trust me, I get flyers like that all the time. I'm like, yo, y'all niggas just want to spell my name the way you want to spell it. Like,
that's why now it makes sense why you spelled it that way. That's creative. That's creative.
Yeah,
that's a cool idea to come up with.
Yeah,
yeah, man. You know, I don't want to be a DJ that just got a name. Like, you just be like, what the hell does that mean? Like, I don't know. I like the name. Like, yeah, all right.
That's a unique name. Like, it makes you stand out, especially out at DC. Because, I mean, no offense to other DJs, there's a lot of basic names out.
Yeah, oh yeah, DJs, trust me, I know.
So, what made you convert from rapping to DJing?
So, crazy story. My boy used to be Jay Holiday's DJ. Shout out to DJ About It, by the way. He had to go on tour. So, at first, I bought turntables for him to do my mixtape. Mm-hmm. Shout out to my dog, Tex Sosa, rest in peace. He took me to buy my first set of turntables mm-hmm. for About It to do my mixtape at Sosa's house.
How old were you at that time?
22.
Okay, young one.
Wait, yeah, I was 22. I think I was 22. Mm-hmm. So yeah, About It was like, yo, I'm gotta go on tour. I need you to cover this party for me. I'm like, I'm not a DJ, bro. Like, how you expect me to cover a party and I'm not a DJ? He was like, nah, this is what I'm gonna do. And this when we were using CDJs, like before Serato became a thing for real. So he's like, yo, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make the CDs, and when one CD is over, you just play the next one. So I did that, mm-hmm. got paid $300, never got a dollar rapping. So he called me the next week, I need you to do it again. Call me next week, I need you to do it again. By the fourth week, the owner was like, yo, you should just do every Friday. I'm like, fine, I'll do every Friday. Didn't know how to DJ, bro, so I literally had to learn in the club, bro. It was, whew.
Which club?
We On Lounge in Landmark Mall.
Oh, Landmark Mall in Alexandria, Virginia?
Yes, sir.
Yo, that's crazy. I didn't even, what was this?
This was 2006, maybe?
I don't even know.
Like, maybe sooner than that.
Because I grew up like in Alexandria. Like,
yeah, it might have been like 06 though.
Oh, that's crazy.
I used to do every Friday at Landmark Mall.
Wow.
Yeah, Landmark and Mall, that's right. How I kind of like came up. And then I got a gig at Ibiza in D.C. And that kind of like turned the curve for
I know.
Me. Like,
that's where you probably got your name, because Ibiza used to be.
By the time I got there, I knew what I was doing.
I couldn't even go there yet.
Yeah, because I'm not lying to you. I had, like, some, like, you know, connects. I was getting there, like, under 21 type.
Yeah,
of
I was crazy.
I wasn't getting in there. That shit was
that over. Was when we had the mega clubs, and it was, like, a thing. Like,
facts, love, all that. You know
yeah, fur, you know, you was going outside. Like, now it's all lounges, but, yeah.
That's actually, that leads me to an interesting question. Do you think, like, back in the day when D.C. had those big mega clubs, was it easier for DJs to kind of make their name? Because now it's, like, so many more DJs, the clubs, there's so many lounges. DJs, because not back in the day, like, restaurants and lounges didn't have DJs. Now everyone has DJs. So what would you think? Like, was it better
back
then?
I say it's easier now because back then it was easier for the DJ that was in position to get a name because you had more of the people that would be at 40 different clubs in that one club. So, you know, it was like, you know, killing plenty of birds with one stone. But now it's like you can kind of go in his own pockets and create your wave and the name. You know, it because if you go all around the city, right, and you ask everybody, like, just name five DJs, right, they're not going to know all five DJs. No matter who you name.
Definitely not.
They're not going to know all five DJs. Yeah. So, like, somebody will know these two. Other people know these two. One person might know all five because they're outside every day. But outside of that, like,
the only people who knows is promoters and probably just club owners, you
exactly.
know?
Exactly. Yeah. So it's really about finding your niche following, and, you know, it'll grow around there. Your name will buzz in other people's ear before they meet you, you know, if you in the right places.
I don't see.
So my other question is, how did you get associated with Freeband Gang?
Man.
And if y'all don't know what Freeband Gang, and I'm pretty sure everyone does, that's Future's label, you know, Future's Collective. Really. And DJ Esco, shout out DJ Esco, because DJ Esco loves the city. And that's what I asked you. So pretty much explain your relationship with Freeband Gang and DJ Esco, because I know you always be with DJ Esco as well.
So with Freebands, it was Barack Obama's first inauguration weekend, and we was at Love.
Shout out to my Obama.
What happened was I was the headline DJ Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at Love that weekend. And Thursday, Friday, I didn't want to do it. No, it was Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Mm-hmm. Thursday was Meek Mill. Friday was Jeezy, I think. And then Saturday was Future.
That's
so
crazy lineup.
The first two nights, I'm like, I'm good. Yeah. It was because it was so lit. I kind of just wanted to, like, chill. Like, I was, you know. That Saturday came. It wasn't even really about it being Future. I was just like, yo, I'm a DJ tonight.
So you weren't nervous or not?
Nah. Hell
had to be,
nah.
Yeah.
So, I mean, but, you know, I ain't going to lie. Like, a lot of times I'll have the nerves before I get, like, even when I was just on tour, like, I'll feel it before I get there. Then once I get on the stage,
you ready to go.
You can't have them nerves no more because it'll throw you all the way off. But basically, I was DJing, and then one of the guys on his team came to the DJ booth, and he was like, yo, we won't put you down with the team, blah, 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 blah. You know what I'm saying? Because I knew I was going, like, what I was going to do. It was Love. Yeah. Like, 18, come on, you know, they going up. Yeah. Like, as long as you're playing the right, they going up.
Anything.
So he was like, yeah, we want to put you part of the team. So he came to the booth, and my laptop was, like, freezing. He's like, yeah, yo.
Oh, shit.
Meet me at the airport. I'm going to get you a new laptop. I was like, all right.
Who? Who told you that?
So my guy, Pro. Oh, okay. His name is Pro. Uh-huh. So basically, next day I wake up, I'm like, I ain't think nothing about it.
Yeah.
I'm like, yo, where you at? I'm like, oh, shit, I'm about to pull up then. Like, I didn't know you were serious.
And you thought he was just talking
shit.
You
had to redownload all your software and all that?
No. My computer was fine.
Oh.
But it just, you know, with technology and the way that it was kind of slow back then, and Serato was, it wasn't new, but, you know, updates and all of that, it was freezing, but it was still playing music.
Oh, okay.
But it'll, like, freeze, and then before the next song, it'll come back. Like, but I was dealing with that, so he's like, nah, let me help you out. So he told me he wanted to put me with an artist named Tess from Baltimore. So he put me with Tess. We just talked on the phone one time, and then one time randomly he called me, like, yo, can you come to Denver? I'm like, when? He was like, tomorrow. It's like, all right, like, not Denver, Arizona. Uh-huh. So I'm like, all right, bet. I go to Arizona. I don't take nothing with me because he ain't give me no real details. So I'm thinking, all right, I'm just going to Arizona for the day. Get to Arizona, and then it's the first day of the Honest Tour.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
You said Honest. I was like, yeah. Man, that was like, that might have been Future's.
That was like his, early peak.
Yeah. I would say it's probably one of his biggest tours.
Yeah. So, well, it wasn't one of the biggest ones, but. Oh. It was just, you know, it was the come up tour. Like, it was when you knew that, okay, the situation is picking up. Like, yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Like, he's about to be a star. For sure.
Yeah.
That's dope. Let's go to my man's Damar. You know, I met him, like, right when Focus opened. I remember you were hustling. You always out here promoting your brand. And I'm like, one thing stand out about you is just the way your design is for your clothing brand is unique. You know, one thing about DMV, I feel like DMV fashion is not appreciated enough, so I want to give everyone their flowers in the DMV fashion industry, because, like, it's not like New York, but we kind of have, we set our own trends as well, too. We take the New York swag with a little Southern swag in it and combine it.
Yeah,
and I feel like that's what your brand kind of does. So pretty much tell us about Frienemies, how you started it, where you from, and what was your inspiration behind it?
All right, so I'm from Washington, D.C. So what got me started on the brand for real is I like to be fly for real, but my parents, you know, they could afford it, but then they couldn't. So, you know, I couldn't always get the new shoes and all the shit other kids had. So, like, damn, you know what I'm saying? Go to school, you know, putting on clothes make you feel good. So, I always want to feel good. So, I'm like, football ain't work out. So, then I left high school, I left college, I started making clothes. I'm like, oh, I can do this. I used to go to high school with, like, just making shit in the house and wasn't even trying to start a brand. People were like, damn, what's that right there? It's different.
That's dope.
But, like, it's just it's a lot to it, though. Mm-hmm. It's a lot. I just try to be different in all ways, all aspects, and just be me, bro.
What made you come up with the name Frienemies? Like, what's, like, the inspiration behind the name?
So,
because it's different, you know. And it's actually, that one word is real shit. You know what I'm saying? It's like,
it's a lot of that. So like, I kind of address, like maybe old problems, old situations. Like, everybody around you ain't for you. You know what I'm saying? Facts. If they get removed,
big facts,
in any kind of way, it was for a reason. So you can't question God on how they left, or, you know what I'm saying? So I'm like, damn, I did this for this person, I did that for this person. But when every time I look around, I don't expect nobody to do nothing for me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? When you always do something for somebody else, or somebody snake you out that you done dealt with for years, or, you know what I'm saying, stuff like that. So I was like, damn, Frienemies, I could put that on the shirt. I just started putting that on the shirt. I put it on my first hoodie. He was pulling up to my house uptown, grabbing them. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I was seeing people on the streets with, like, damn, oh, yeah, they go Frienemies. Now I go in the store, be like, oh, ain't you the nigga that make Frienemies? I'm like, yeah, that's me, bro. So it feel good, but then, like, I just try to get out there more, like, push it more, because it's definitely a different way.
So have you, so question, have you had, like, any, like, artists or, like, notable people, like, reach out to you about it? You know, because a lot of people nowadays, you know, social media.
I have, but it ain't falling how it was supposed to.
I feel that.
But that shit ain't going to stop me. I'm going to keep going. And then when it's my turn, when I get there, the people who you know what I'm saying, oh, promote this for me, bro. Guys, people, bro. They just going to have to pay for it. That's all. It's going to be swag, and it's definitely going to be top notch. I promise.
Do you get, like, a lot of traction from other areas? Like, have you, like, went to New York and Atlanta? Because I feel like I'm like, you know, DMV again. You know, I don't like to always keep bashing the DMV.
It's a box.
It's hard to kind of, like, come up in DMV. But I feel like if you had that in Atlanta or New York, they would be on that. So try to, like, go different areas?
Because I got kids, too. So one time me and my son were in New York, we kind of had the same outfit on. I had the Frienemies coat. Shit like that. People stop. I was like, damn, where y'all get this coat from? I'm like, man, I'm making myself. Like, no, get the fuck out of here. I'm like, nah, I really make this myself. So it feel good to go to other places. Like Miami, I had a lot of people stop me from my hand-painted T-shirt that I did in the house. Stop me. Like, you need to start coming here doing pop-ups. I just ain't reached that level for me to move around and be mobile as much. But when I do, I'm out there.
Man, you at that level now, bro. It's literally just about you making the time and setting that shit aside and hitting that fucking road, bro.
Exactly. Cause I'm not there. Like, that's like a top notch brand, bro. Yeah. To be honest, it's like you're, like, right up there with Museum and Eat. Like, my three favorite is you, Eat, Museum. No offense to any other clothing brands, but right now from DMV, it's Museum, Eat, and y'all. Like, y'all three.
Shout out Pussies Not Motion.
Oh,
shout out to Community Love too. Yeah,
and Sucker Free too. No,
like, and Sucker Free. Dope. Those are my brothers.
Sucker Free's dope. There's actually a lot of actually dope clothing brands coming out of DMV industry. I feel like we just have to all kind of. One thing I would say too, and actually, let me make this message right now. I feel like us as minorities, we need to stop buying designer. Like, fuck that designer.
Oh, yeah.
We need to support our local owned black owned brands. Like, that designer shit's for the birds. I'm gonna tell y'all that right now. A lot of people gonna probably hate me for this, but, like, we giving money to people that don't give nothing. Like, no, I'm not trying to say that word.
They meet you. They not gonna talk to you. They won't even take a picture with you.
And they don't put no money behind the communities and stuff like that. But if we help push our own brand, because at the end of the day, I feel like we're, like, the biggest market when it comes to designer. Like, we the ones who buy it. And most times, individuals can't even afford it. So I feel like, to be honest, we should be supporting our own black-owned businesses and, like, our own clothing brands as well. So I like that, you know, you started that, made that initiative, because most people would have just been like, you know, I'm just trying to buy something else if I can't afford this. But instead, you just, you know, got resourceful and you made it yourself. So I like that. So you definitely get your flowers for that.
And I like when say if I'm in the house making something, I like when I make a mistake, because you got to think of it. Like, you can't make a mistake with art. There's no mistake in art.
So if
I fuck up on something, I just put something together, and then boom, I got another design.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So I fuck with that. I love when I fuck up in art.
Nah, facts. Because art's all about just whatever comes to your mind and how it just creates. You know what I'm saying?
There's no right, wrong, or right way to do it.
Exactly.
Hell no.
That's what even come with music. Like, when artists be, like, producing music and stuff, they be just saying one crazy thing. They're like, oh, this joint actually kind of fire. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's all part of the creative process. Next question I got is for both y'all. What's some obstacles that y'all faced, you know, you being a DJ, you know, being a DJ, we had Schemes last time, you know, he was telling us, you know, nowadays, you know, as you said, it's harder to get traction as a DJ because there's so many DJs now media's out there. Yeah. Anyone can book. I'm not gonna lie to y'all. I know someone that was doing something else. He became a DJ within 2 weeks and now he's pretty good. You know what I'm saying? So the thing about DJing is one of those crafts that you can easily grasp, but being that top DJ is very hard to get to that point as well too. And then, you know, you as a brand owner, you know, fashion's really hard. I know a lot of times, even with the cost behind it in the beginning, startup clothing brands, it takes a while and you have to, you know, kind of push and keep, you know, marketing it. So for both of y'all, like, what's some obstacles that y'all face and how did y'all kind of like accomplish that? I'll let you go first, Joe Iyce.
I mean, for me, so most of my obstacles was that I never really was the one to like go chase promoters and like look for bookings through that wave, right? Mm-hmm. So if, let's say, for example, the first time I went on tour, right, I was a house DJ at Stadium. So, like, I always end up in situations to where, like, the club want to, like, hold me at the club. So, like, I really don't got to search for bookings all over the place or, you know what I'm saying? And then everything else I get is extra. But when I was there and I went on tour, I came back, and all the other gigs that I had, like, with other promoters and stuff was, like, you know, they're all gone. I'm gone for 3 months. They done been dealing with this guy for 2 months, yeah. This guy, you know what I'm saying? So it's just, like, it's just being able to, the obstacle is really like building your brand, right? And getting out of the mindset of needing other people to build your brand, if that makes any sense. No, like, I started doing my own events and I started working with people who I did more consistent work with, you know, versus having to keep trying to chase, go to this club. Hey, man, you remember, like, I used to text your phone, like, right, bro, you know, what's up, blah, 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 blah. But there's only a few people that I would hit, you know what I'm saying, to see what's up, whatever, because I've always had something to hold me down regardless, you know what I'm saying? So I ain't never really end up having it. Plus, like I said, with me dealing with Future and Tess and a lot of other artists that I deal with, it helped me build a brand for myself that, like, I can literally call a promoter in Vegas and be like, yo, I'm trying to come out there in the next 2-3 weeks, and I'm there. Chicago, I could do the same thing. Miami, I could do the same, you know what I'm saying?
I was going to ask you a question, because so you being a radio DJ, mm-hmm, does that help you out in getting bookings and knowing artists? Because I feel like being a radio DJ, that definitely gives you an advantage. You meet a lot of artists. You get opportunities with a lot of people. Because even, like, I'm out to, you know, I promote at the clubs as well, too. From a promoter perspective, I would want to get a DJ who work in a radio DJ, because they're going to promote the club and everything. And they have more following from my eyes. So being a radio DJ, how does that differ, you know, from just not being a radio DJ? Does it
I mean, the honest difference is, because it is, as far as promotion goes, a lot of the DJs don't talk on the radio.
They don't.
You know what I'm saying? So there's no real promotion you're going to get out of that. But, like, for DJs, the quickest way to build your brand is to align it with other brands. See what I'm saying? So I got Freebands, I got KYS, Sway in the Morning, you know, doing all this other stuff. People look at the resume, and then that's what separates you from the guy who just hops from this club to that club to this club and that club. Because then when they promote you, they got other things that they can add to the flyer or, you know, to the verbiage. You know, it's this guy from this versus, like, this guy from last week or, you know.
Like, it's easier for people to, like,
they're like familiarity, like,
yeah, exactly,
shit that they're familiar with. Yeah, well, whether they know about it that much or not, as long as they heard, oh, he's from that, like, oh, all right, let's check him out, like.
So would you recommend, like, a new DJ to, like, try to always kind of get a gig in the radio? Like, you know, radio's kind of dying now. It's still there, but, like, would you, like, nowadays? Because, I mean, social media, now you can do everything on social media.
I would always recommend radio because it's, like, it's free positioning. You know what I'm saying? At worst, like, whoever they're interviewing at the station, I can go up to the everybody who's there and be like, yo, I want to do an interview, too. And they'll just put me, okay, well, after whoever's interviewing them now, you go in there. You know, I don't got to look for that.
It's easy for you to build your
brand.
They're
coming there.
They're giving you a platform.
When I'm in other cities or even when I'm in home, mm-hmm, and you're dealing with the artist that the people want to get to, they're going to jump to the conversation of the guy who can actually play his song on the radio, because the spins still go towards Billboard. That's how you chart. That's what they want to do. You know what I'm saying? The club spins don't do that. Certain clubs, they have a system now where it counts, but it doesn't count as much as a radio spin.
Oh, yeah, I heard about that. I was trying to kind of, like, implement that, you know, over there at Focus as well, too. But I think you got to have, like, some type of connection.
Yeah,
with that.
It's like a playlist kind of thing you got to set up with Media Base and BDS. I mean, like, once again, you can do it, but, you know, it's not as valuable. It just shows that music is being played, what songs are being played at your club.
How about you, Damar? Like, tell us about some obstacles that you faced as, you know, a brand owner, designer.
When I first started out, for real, I had a lot of people, like, rocking with me for like a big ass, like a big group of people. You know what I'm saying? I had just a patch. I started off with a patch and a t-shirt. Like we went out, took pictures and stuff like that. We did it big though. But like, so when I first started out, the obstacles I ran through is like getting other people in the city to like support your shit. Like pushing it, you know, like really pushing it. So I ain't really had that problem. So I was just like, you know what? I ain't gonna give up. I gotta keep going. I gotta make something different. And then I started making shit different. I was selling hoodies. I used to sell hoodies probably like $80. Now I'm selling $300 hoodies. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Because I didn't give up. And I still like, I got people that come to me and spend $1,000. Like they in the store or something. Like, yeah, bro, put it together. I need that different shit. I put it together. They swag that shit out. They get the compliments. They get the likes and the
they looks. Wanted more.
Nah, yeah. Facts. So you didn't really you didn't face that many like obstacles in the beginning because of like the initial support.
And I spent a lot
support.
Of money. I recently just got like $2,000 took it from me. I lost a lot of money in clothes. Like it'd be
cost. Yeah, I would so definitely go. You probably say cost is probably the biggest thing when it comes. Like if you had to give someone like that's trying to start their own clothing brand, the hardest thing's probably the cost behind like you know producing it and all that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely.
Okay, that's dope.
Definitely
the cost. Next question I got for both y'all. It's kind of like a fun one. Groupie love. How y'all deal with that? You know, being a DJ, I know how that is. And then, you know, having being an entrepreneur, clothing brand, but still trying to focus on, you know, your goals and stuff. And especially nowadays with social media and everyone trying to, you know, be famous and all that stuff. How do you deal with that? I know, especially you being DJ and knowing big artists, sometimes, you know, how do y'all deal with the groupie love?
I'm married, bro. Only reason why I ain't got my ring on is because my hands swollen, my fingers swollen. You feel me? But I got in the car accident, just, you know what I'm saying? I'm a little banged
glad
up. My hands is all twisted up. But, yeah, bro, I mean.
So you that, having a wife and being in a club as a DJ, that's probably hard,
like,
right?
That's an obstacle.
That's what I was going to say.
But, you know, I mean, you got to be more headstrong. And to be honest, like, we've all had our downfalls and our moments and, you know, I wish a DJ would say that he ain't had a moment where he got caught up doing some dumb shit, you know. But, like, after a while, you start to realize, like, the outside girls are not really worth a goddamn thing. So it's kind of like you putting that energy into that takes away from the energy you need to be putting into yourself. You feel what I'm saying? Like, anytime I find myself spreading myself thin, and it's like, okay, I got to take care of home. I got kids at home. I got wife at home. I got my career. And then somebody else is on my phone talking some, all this crazy shit. Like, yeah. Nah.
It's not worth it.
It's not worth it. Because, you know, they get clingy, bro. Like, you open the space up, and then they start showing up to where you at uninvited. Yeah. And you might have a whole nother guest with you. Like, nah, I got to balance this. I got two girlfriends outside. Like, nah, hell nah. That's
somebody
not
gonna die. Fuck around.
You see what
like
I'm
that.
Saying?
Nah.
So, and then nowadays, it's even hard with social media. They gonna catch you.
Like, yeah, it's not worth it. And that is the quickest way. There's phones everywhere, bro.
Yeah, nah, for real.
If I was a DJ in the 80s, let me tell you, bro. I wouldn't even. Shit.
I feel you.
It's a whole nother situation today, bro. Like,
yeah,
you can't play outside.
Very invasive. Like, you know what I'm saying? You have no privacy.
Bro, there are people waiting for you to fuck up so they can literally
invade that space.
Tear your shit up. Like, there's an angry girl or angry dude. Somebody is just like, can't wait.
And I'm not lying to you. This city, like, D.C. is very small. Like, it might be big, but it's, like, in terms
everybody
of, like, a lot of people.
Nightlife and the outside life, yeah.
And nightlife's even worse. Yeah, everyone in nightlife know each other. I'm going to tell you right now. Working in a club, like, you think that someone doesn't know them, and then you be like, nah, I know them.
What's it called? 6 degrees of separation?
Yeah. Nah, club is, like, 2 degrees.
It's, like, two, yeah. It's, like, okay, you know her. She doesn't know you, but her friend knows you and him and him.
They didn't talk about you.
All it takes is one conversation. She be like, oh, hell.
It's over. How about you, Damar? How you deal with the groupie love? And staying focused.
Yeah, because you made the clothes, so you know they coming.
I got a girl, so you know she got her head on her shoulders. She got her own business too, so.
Oh, nice.
We just support each other.
Yeah, that's
so
good.
I feel like you said, that shit don't be worth it. For us,
it don't be worth it, bro.
And the clothes, I that's the part my girl don't understand sometimes. Like, it's, I wouldn't say you put yourself in certain situations, but me, I make clothes. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to have to. Dress
interact,
I feel you.
It's hard, bro, because you know how females are. It's hard.
It's the photographers I'd be worried about.
So the one thing nowadays too is like, all right, let's keep it real. I'm in the promotion realm, I'm in media industry, entertainment. Women are very one of the vital things when it comes to marketing.
Yeah.
So as your brand, sometimes you're gonna have to like you know interact with these women.
Oh, yeah.
to push your
brand.
You
gotta have friends and like, exactly. Nobody wants a DJ that shows up and don't know girls ever come. Yeah. Like, yeah. Like, damn, he ain't got no mission like that. Yeah.
Then your people's at home just might be like, oh, you gonna be.
Every
like,
time you got girls around, it's called balance. Balance. If you don't have balance, dog, with everything in life, trust me, something's gonna tip over. Yeah, no, and it ain't gonna tip in the right way. You got to definitely be in control of that.
Nah, facts. It's all about balance. It's back to, like, you know, being an entrepreneur, brand owner, business. It's all about managing your time and balancing everything. You know what I'm saying? Not too much of something. But I definitely understand how that goes. All right, let's go to the hot topics. So first hot topic is the rise of female artists. I'll go with you first, JO Iyce. Kind of, like, give me your opinion. Why you think female artists are kind of, like, you know, succeeding now? Like, I'm not lying to you. When I be in the club now, DJs, six in a row. Female artists. That's back in the day. That would never, you
never
know.
Happen.
But nowadays, six in a row. Like, sometimes you'd be like, a DJ have a whole set, all female artists.
Mm-hmm.
And then the thing about it is, then you put a male artist on and the DJ not vibing no more. I mean, the club not vibing no more. Then you got to put that female artist, then everyone vibes.
It's
because
of that energy. Yeah, so, you know, and kinda, the songs that they make is like, you know, if they're playing a female song in the club, I mean, shout out to all my female artists out there. But 95% of the songs is like, shake that ass, da da blah, blah, blah. It's like telling them to do some ratchet shit if they're playing it in the club. Not exactly. The songs that, you know, all the music they make, but the ones that they're going to play in the club, it's like, for that, it's made for that motion.
Exactly.
So it's like, now it works out because the women are supporting each other now.
Hey, you just hit a gem right there. That's actually, I was going to bring that up too. I feel like back in the day, let's keep it real, guys go out to the club, go out, even now, to see women, you know what I'm saying? But you just said a key thing. Now women understand, like, they're the market.
Yep.
So women's like, I already know what I want to hear. Because if girls are vibing in the club, guys don't give a fuck, like, exactly. What they're listening to. But so now it's these female artists, they understand what they want to hear. They play that song.
They got the men singing that shit.
Yeah.
Come on.
I'm like, keep guys.
Sexy Riz got.
Come on. It's town, town.
Yeah. Nah,
like,
for
you
real.
Can't even get it out of your head. Even if you don't like it, it just be like in your head. Because it would make sense. I was watching the Wallow and the Gilly podcast. $1 million podcast, and they were talking about that they went to go to Jackson State with what's his name, Deion Sanders, his team, and then you know what they were cranking? They were like, put on that Glorilla.
Yeah,
they didn't say Future or nothing. They said pulling out Glorilla, football players, young football players. So it's crazy.
I had an argument with somebody that Glorilla. They was like, that's her one hit. That's she's gonna be done. At I said, bro, you
she
crazy?
Has the other one. She got the tomorrow too.
She's gonna be around for a while.
She crank, bro. She not going nowhere.
Yeah, and she can rap actually. Over. She's a little bit different from like the other. In my opinion, I feel like
she
can
be
spit.
Popping her shit. Like and she different.
Not fact.
She gonna be around for a while.
Yeah, see, good. I had an argument on the phone. I'm like, bro, I'm telling you,
nah,
it's not her only. No, fuck.
They
go
like
go
you
crazy.
Said, they get it. Like they know what to do. Like us. That when I say us, I mean like the guy rappers. They go in there and try to overthink making a song. Okay. So that's why like a lot of the artists that approach me with club music, I'd be like, nigga, what club you think this shit gonna work in? Like, it don't be that. But the women, they know. Like, I'm gonna talk about this ass. I'm gonna say something else. I'm gonna say something else nasty. And you know, unfortunately, that's what it is, but that's just what it is. Like, you know what I'm saying? In the car, it might be you might have some other tunes for the car, but for the club, ain't nobody trying to hear no female artist talking no Nas type shit or no nigga talking no Nas shit. So it's just like,
that's true. They understand the market, and I feel like they're killing it. So shout out to all the female artists.
You gotta get in there and just get as ratchet as you can.
And I feel like they doing well with it too, because they mixing up like a boy and a girl on a song, but like they talking they shit like on some relationship type shit. Like, oh, she arguing with me, I'm gonna argue back with her, but they transform it into a song, and that shit make it look sweet.
I think it's also the labels utilizing the females in the right way now, because now they know that the females artists are more marketable. So they're like, all right, I'm gonna put the feature with this guy. Like, because before it was just like, okay, I got a female artist, they don't really put no marketing around her,
and they were clickish, like, so they like they kept them separate. Like, it was like, you go at this one, and you go at that.
They were trying to put that.
They were going at each other, and it was like, for what? Like, I don't even want to hear y'all talk. Like, even some of them now, like, I don't want to hear y'all talk that gangster ass, street ass, I'll pop a nigga ass shit.
They be talking that shit.
Get off that shit. I don't care, because if you ain't really about to run down on no nigga on no block and do none of that shit, and you ain't toting this and toting that.
And it doesn't even sound right, to be
honest.
Don't
even do it because you think that's what niggas want to hear, because that's not what we want to hear.
Definitely not. We already hear enough of that.
I'd rather hear you rap like
bars.
Like J. Cole.
Lady London.
Then
shout out to Lady London from New York.
I love Lady London.
She actually got bars.
She
knows how to, like, it's not like.
It's like she's talking to you. It's like a conversation in a song.
Yeah. I feel like maybe. I love her. Do you think it's also because of her looks that she's a little bit like? Because I mean, this rap shawty, I think from West Coast, she's tough. She got bars, but no one really be like paying attention to her. But Lady London, they pay attention to her. But it's also, you know, she look prettier. She got the looks as well.
She got a lot of substance, bro.
Yeah, she does have substance too. She talks bars.
Yeah, like it's just real in depth substance, like. Everybody don't have that. You know what I'm saying?
So. And she still makes some bangers too. I think there's one song that's, you probably heard of it too, Damar. I forgot what's the song. What's that song? I forgot the name, line. But yeah. But shout out to Lady London and all the other female artists. Next topic, NBA Finals. I don't know if y'all watch basketball. What's y'all opinion on like how the NBA Finals is? It's kind of like different this year. Like it's not the same teams. Warriors are out. LeBron is still in it. The Lakers still in it. But Jokic is unstoppable.
Yeah.
So what's y'all opinion? And who y'all think is going to win the NBA Finals?
So my thing is, I'm like, I never really been into sports until I got on FanDuel.
Yo, FanDuel crazy.
FanDuel.
It's a hate and love relationship.
Let me tell you.
My shit don't work.
There's a dude on Twitter. His name is, hold on. I got to tell you his name because y'all got to follow this man.
What's
right
he do?
Here.
Like, he does like FanDuel stuff.
Let me tell you something. I ran into his page randomly yesterday. Hold on.
Don't tell me he got the gems, because I'd be on parlay signs.
He dropped an impossible parlay. I'm going to tell it to you right now. Hold on. His name is something Eli.
I feel like I know. I feel like I've seen that.
Oh, my God. I posted it this morning, bro. This guy basically posted a $5 parlay.
It was probably mad legs. It was probably like.
Baseball. Oh, six shit. Leg parlay, uh-huh. Right? Okay, so his name is at DEGEN Eli. So he posted all these. It was a four leg parlay. My bad. For home runs, bro. $5. Look at the cash out, sir.
What the hell?
$5.
$8,000. And $26, and he only put up $5. That's crazy.
See, $5.
That stuff kind of stuff made me pissed off because it's like, damn, why can't I hit that shit?
Well, for me personally, I think like sports are rigged, so it's kind of like I'm just gambling anyway. You know what I'm saying?
I feel like that's how it is too, because I feel like some of the stuff is like you barely hit them every time, and it's like, how can everyone have that same story? I feel like the
dude
setup.
Will come, he'll drop 85 today. Donovan Mitchell will drop 85, and then come back the next game and drop 15.
That's crazy.
Like, how in the hell is that even possible?
Do y'all
bro?
Think people are just watching sports now because of FanDuel? Y'all think
I mean,
like,
there's a lot of people picking it up because of
I mean,
FanDuel.
Look at yourself. You don't even watch sports. Nah, I'm not how about even, you, Damar?
I used to love sports. I ain't going to lie. But I've been too focused on what I got going on. So.
I feel you.
I worry about the sports when they got this shit on their back and when they walk.
There you go. Back. There you go.
Who y'all got? But who y'all predicting to win the championship? Boston, Miami, Lakers, or the Nuggets?
I'm going to say Denver.
Denver?
I'd say the Lakers.
Lakers?
Yeah,
I'd say LeBron, I don't know, man. He's
LeBron,
like,
my favorite.
I told you, I don't even. I haven't been in the sports right now, I swear.
Nah, I'm hip.
I've been in my sketchbook hard as shit.
The two things I used to be on when I was younger, I'm off, which is sports. And I used to be a gamer. Like, I used to play video games.
I'd be on Call of Duty.
That shit like, distracted me so bad in life.
Now, I feel like being like in business or having your own brand, it's kind of hard to have like that. Personal downtime. Time to see all that, especially the older you get when you have kids and all that.
Exactly. And I got kids and I don't sleep at all.
Not fast. Because I feel like our sleep schedule as entrepreneurs and like people in this industry, it's like it's different. Like we don't have like a consistent time. Like we can be working in the middle of the night sometimes.
Man,
you know?
I get my ass up, bro. If I feel like I got a design. I'm getting up. Not I don't fast. Care if it's 3:00. I don't care what time. I'm
I actually like
up.
Doing stuff in the nighttime, like brainstorming. I feel like it's clear. No one bothering me and all
that.
Yeah, you
know that
I feel like that's a creative thing.
2 to 4 or 5 windows, fact. Like
that's my favorite.
When nobody's bothering me,
like
and
everything
stay
is
up
quiet.
The rest of the day. Nah, I'll probably sleep 3 more hours.
That's part of the life, though. That grind. All right, next topic I got for y'all is RICO cases in the rap culture. Do y'all think that the let's call it the hip hop police right now are coming at? Hip like rap specifically.
Man.
Like when it's RICO, like do you think RICO was literally built? I mean it was built before with Mar, but like
but
I'm saying
still,
it's
like,
but built to take down the hip hop culture because they saw all these artists, successful minorities pushing RICO. Back in the street, like putting the money in the streets, but they can't catch them. So now they put these RICO cases where they can just say anything, like, oh, he gave them money to do all this. So like what do y'all think about what's y'all opinion about the RICO cases in the rap
in
culture?
My honest fucking opinion. from the bottom of my soul, mm-hmm. these rappers are fucking dumb.
They are too.
There's no fucking way that anybody should be able to trace any crime or anything that you've done through a fucking song. Bro, I sat in a studio session because I make beats too, right? Mm-hmm. Man, hand on 20 stacks of Bibles. He going through the beats, pick out the songs he wanted to. We start recording all the songs. Things just started like, yeah, you know, I meet my plug down at blah, 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 blah. I'm just like,
yo, you snitching, bro, on yourself?
And then when you get jammed up in some shit and they want to use it against you, like, you can't use my lyrics against me, they just lyrics. But then you got a video on YouTube and you like, I'm a real nigga. Everything I rap about is my truth. I ain't nothing capping my rap.
And then you go on Instagram Live and do the same thing.
And you just adding more shit to it, and you flashing guns and you holding up money. Like, nigga, you asking to go to jail, like, and then you cry when they like, oh, it's a RICO, and then you, that YSL shit is insane, bro.
It's insane.
That shit, if you know the backstory and see like what really transpired before all them niggas went to jail, they was asking for that shit.
I mean, yeah, you could.
Niggas,
I mean,
shot up nigga house, put in the song. Did this, put in the song.
I heard like there was one where this dude was robbing like females, and then Lily was in one of Young Thug's song.
Put it in the song, like. So
you think they just send them?
What more evidence do I need besides you saying it in the song? Like, you know, yeah, it's just a song, but nigga, somebody made a police report about this, and in the same, and in one of your latest songs, you said you did this. Like, even Dirk, I don't understand how that nigga's not in jail.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is kind of crazy.
He be saying some crazy shit.
Crazy.
They slid on my brother and they all did and da-da and ha-ha and that's why you got hit with a headshot and we know who did it. And
his lawyer keeps getting them off.
Damn. Shout out to nigga, what are you doing? It'll come eventually.
And it's like you can talk about so much other stuff. Like you're at that point where you're already successful. I feel like when you get to that point, you don't need... I feel like in their head, they're like, okay... The audience just want to hear this part. But
yeah, niggas are programmed, bro.
I feel like it's entertainment, but a lot of the younger people are jive, you know, like feeding into it a little bit more than they supposed to. Like, because when they hear this shit, you know, like when you in a car, you hear a song, that shit make you want to go turn
it
up on somebody.
Go do it.
You know what I'm saying? So I think they more influenced by it and not like, because a lot of younger people now, they don't got older people to tell them what to do.
Facts.
It's a lot of youngers out here like, oh man, our old heads don't tell us what to do. We run this shit. Like,
they being raised by the music.
Yeah, and like the youngers, like, don't play with them. You know what I'm saying?
I mean,
they'll bust your old ass. Nah, you know what I mean?
A lot of young, they don't have OGs running like that area. It's more of like young niggas raising young niggas. Like, you know what I'm
100%.
Saying?
So, yeah, shit, my generation ain't have it, so I know the niggas younger than me. Shit, because I know their parents type shit. Like, nigga, if that's your daddy, God damn it, boy.
Nah, you crazy outside. Nah, that's crazy. Well, hopefully, you know what I'm saying, this joint chills out and y'all artists are smarter than what y'all are. And
man, wake the fuck up and clean up your shit.
Y'all
like,
tripping.
Be like J. Cole or something and shit.
I seen McMill pull up on some youngers that. You seen that?
Nah.
He pulled up on some youngers that he told them rap for him and they was cursing too much and shit. He like, man, tone it down a notch. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got to curse so much to tell what you went on. You ain't got to talk about go hitting somebody with a Drake and shit like that. I was like, oh, yeah, that's all right.
Not fact. Yeah, and especially, I'm not like, I got another message. DC artists especially. Like, y'all need to, like,
everything
y'all all sound the same, to be honest.
And sliding and stepping.
It's literally like there's a starter kit. I'm not like, shout out to, what's not Goofy? What's that other comedian, Bebe?
Yeah.
Like, he be doing jokes off that. Like, and Goofy, too, like, to be honest. And they kind of, like, depict that in a funny way, but it's real. Like
they cranking that shit though. Like how they put it together, it's starting to sound. I wouldn't say like the drill music in New York, but I heard a couple songs the other day. I don't really listen to that shit, but that shit jive. Like
I feel like they have the potential, but it's just like y'all gotta talk about something more.
It has the potential, but it's like bad timing because like it's like in a time where niggas don't control their own mind.
Exactly.
So it's like, and then they coming out with more shit for you not to control your own mind. So it's like now you got AI and all this other shit. You ain't got to think no more. It's you just straight being programmed.
Wow,
for sure. Your TV, your radio, like.
I mean, you got ChatGPT. You don't got to do
man,
no work now.
Just
type
bro.
All that.
John Morant did his apology letter
in
that motherfucker.
Yo, that's like, hey, John Morant. I'm disappointed.
He's an idiot. You have your friends. Get away from your friends. Those are not your goddamn friends,
and actually,
friends,
that's the definition of degeneration. Like, y'all should learn from John Morant. Like, this dude's a superstar basketball player, and he's still doing dumb stuff like that. And look where he's about to end up. He about to, because the NBA not going to give him another chance.
They that's a friend of me for your ass. You don't even know it.
Facts.
He's sitting right next to you, like, knowing you just got suspended for having a gun, he going to pull his phone out and then,
See, and that's the people I'm more disappointed is the friends. Like, if my man's a basketball player, I'm like, yo, what are you doing, bro? Like,
protect that.
Like, let the other ones do that. Not why you
definitely
got
to get him as a friend of me.
Come on, bro. You definitely got
to
get him.
Shout out to my man, Damar.
And some new friends.
All right, let's go to the last hot topic, the banning of TikTok. You know, TikTok's going crazy. But I said it from the beginning. I always talk TikTok with some brainwashed stuff. It's a Chinese app. But TikTok has definitely helped a lot of music artists, a lot of brands. People started a lot of stuff off TikTok. TikTok's like Google, but it's just like, it's quick. Like, you can learn everything from TikTok. Do y'all think it's beneficial or y'all think it should be banned?
So the only downside of TikTok, and well, there's a few. But the major downside is that them people have all of our information, like all of our information. All the government people, they have all their children's information. That's like right. They have everything, addresses, whatever they need. When it's oppie time, the China boys can come over here and do whatever they need to do and knock on doors. But outside of that, I mean, once again, we in an era where people don't think for themselves. So they do what other people do. Like, you know, there's some people who everything they post, they doing a dance somebody else is doing, or they doing something else somebody else is doing. Why? To gain the same attention that person has. You know what I'm saying? Versus like back in the day when we had Black Planet and MySpace and shit, we was literally making our page to like, for who we are.
Unique.
You come to my shit, this is what I am, this is what I do. You're not gonna see me doing what they doing on this page because that's that page. Like, we don't do that over here.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? But I mean, outside of that, you can learn a lot. I've learned a lot on TikTok, just life hacks and even, you know, just, I don't know. I mean, but I guess like everything else is like the good and the bad. You know what I'm saying?
Facts.
But would I say ban it? I wouldn't say ban it, but I would say put an age limit on it.
Filter it.
I feel like you should be at least be 18 to be facts. Able to. Especially because there's no like real filter on there.
There's
like,
no real. There's nothing on that. Like,
it goes from Hello Kitty to pussy. Like,
some of that shit be brainwashing the kids too.
I
per se like the new homosexual world that we live in. Yeah. You know, no offense to nobody, but it's like the way they build it to or program it to the kids in the elementary.
It's just more of like they show it too early. Like, you know what I'm saying? They don't give the parents a chance to kind of expose it to them. It's like
that's
everywhere.
I got kids too, so.
That shit is just different.
I feel like
I was gonna ask you. I was gonna say, okay, y'all both have kids. Y'all would let them have TikTok, like what, or is there an age limit?
No, my kids can't get it.
My kids got TikTok, but my daughter's 17.
Oh yeah, so you good? But would there be a limit? Like, what? How old would y'all like let y'all kids?
I got teenagers, so
I don't have teenagers. I have babies. Like, they still right. So
yeah, like
I let them get on the phone, but it's certain shit I don't like them watch, like YouTube too.
Hey, YouTube's
shit.
Wild.
Yeah, YouTube.
Wow. I limit their social media though. Like, they don't have like Instagram and all that other stuff. Like, got TikTok, who they got TikTok. And I still like monitor their phone, like just to.
Yeah, there's apps now where you can like do all that.
I got all that daddy shit, bro. Trust me. I know where they are right now and everything.
I'm gonna lie to you. When I get a kid, like, I'm tracking them until they're 17. And this.
I'm tracking them for the rest of their life.
Yeah, I don't know about after 18.
I just want you to know that. You watching.
Facts.
You know.
All right, let's go to the next topic. Just some quick, like, you know, fun stuff. I'm going to give y'all, like, three words, and y'all kind of, like, give me what first comes to your head. Like, if I say female basketball player, I'll say Candace Parker type thing. Just, you know, whatever comes to your head. Something fun.
They have right now.
And I'm gonna start off, I'll be like, you know, I'll go to you first and give you a word, and I'll go to you, and then you get a word. All right. So, fashion brand.
Frenemies.
Okay, yeah. I like that. DC artist. First thing that comes to your head. Who's a?
Damn, why would you do that, bro?
It's a couple of them.
I know. That's fine.
Hey, Mo, I just told you.
It's a couple of them, bro. Like, I ain't going to lie. I just heard.
First artist.
Shit, why would you do that,
you hear DC artist, first artist.
It's a lot of them.
I know, but no offense, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no offense. Favorite, I just don't know which one my favorite for real.
Nah, he ain't say favorite.
Just first artist that come. When I say DC artist, what comes to your head? Who's the artist?
Oh, Free No Savage. I would go.
Okay. Shout out to No Savage and Free No Savage. Female rapper.
First name that comes to my head? Nikki.
Childhood show.
Tom and Jerry.
Tom and Jerry. I like that. Chasing the rat. Boy, you from the hood for real. Yeah. Tom and Jerry, nigga. Sure. No raps allowed.
Celebrity crush.
Oh, Bernice Burgos. Fuck you. Fuck you mean.
Role model.
A role model. I just met my real role model.
Who?
Ian Connor. That's my real Ian Connor,
the videographer?
He a stylist, bro.
Oh. Stylist. Oh, you talking about Ian Connor? He used to work with Playboy V-Long, and all that. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Virgil.
I forgot. Bro. I was like, what happened to Ian Connor? Ian Connor is sexy.
Fucking goat, bro.
Yeah. He low-key was.
That's my new one.
Where'd you meet him?
I ain't even meet him. Oh. My man gave me the Instagram yesterday.
That's how you know your shit, inspiration bro. Is real when you're a role model from a distance. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
I ain't even meet him.
It's just the energy I put in the universe.
Nah, facts.
I was watching
that.
Clips on them all day yesterday. I'm like, this is right.
All right, last question, and then I'm going to let y'all do, like, you know, we're going to wrap up. What's y'all opinions on? This is why the question I always ask everyone, you know, we're from the DMV. What y'all think about the current state of the DMV culture? Joe Iyce, you want to go first?
Current state of the culture. Okay. I feel like it's all over the place. Because when I say that, it's like, so many people doing so many different things, but in 30 fucking thousand different directions.
Facts.
Instead of, like, everybody coming together and making it make sense and creating a, like, look at Atlanta. You know what I'm saying? Atlanta artists get hot. There's another one coming out next week. That nigga's putting on another one the week after. Another one, you know what
it's
I'm saying?
Consistency. He's a lot wearing of clothes. Mm-hmm.
Like, all the branding that is imaginable to come out of that shit is coming out of the videographers. You finding out about the producers. Everybody's going to this producer this time. Everybody's going to that producer that time. You know what I'm saying? All of that shit. Like, even with the go-go culture here, it's like falling off the radar because it doesn't get the support that it used to get back in the day from down to the venues to, you know, just people actually wanting to promote it. It's just a lot that needs to be preserved here. But everything is here that we need, resource-wise. It's just us not, like, looking at each other and like, yo, you got a podcast, let me come on your show. Yo, you got a fashion label, let me do whatever we can do. You know what I'm saying? To promote, like, the first conversation we had when we met. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? How can we, who do I need to call? To put them on the phone with the people from Love & Hip Hop. Like, shit like that. Until we continuously do shit like that for each other, it's going to be crabs in the barrel. Niggas going to be going every direction. We're going to be right here.
I agree with that. Because, like, even me, like, trying to have a media outlet in a DMV and trying to connect people is hard. It's hard. A lot of people don't want to work together, or maybe this establishment doesn't want that artist, or they don't want rap music there. It's very hard. Like, no one really, it's harder to support DMV, but we do have it all here. Like, I had a tweet earlier. I was like, we got all the tools, but no connection.
Yeah. Like, no mechanic.
Yeah. And that's the thing. We have, like, we have smoke shops, clothing brands, rappers, DJs, singers, like, you know, people who own, and we have a lot of black owners who have, like, a lot of venues in here and stuff like that as well, too. So that's I definitely agree with what you just said. How about you, Damar? What do you think about the DMV culture?
Back on what Joe Iyce say, we just gotta work together for real. Put each other in better positions. Stop, you know, hating one another. Stop being frenemies. You know,
we definitely gotta
stop doing that. And it's basically because somebody don't want to see you doing better than them, but it's really not about doing better than somebody. Like, I do shit off the strength. Like, I just hit Joe Iyce, like, what time, like 12 o'clock, mm-hmm. something like that. Holler at my man, Haru. Mm-hmm. Holler at Haru.
Shout out to Haru.
Holler at Haru. Like, yeah, he can put some shit together and y'all can go crazy. Like, I just seen a vision. Like, I be working all over the, you know what I'm saying, to put P together. I come up with ideas for certain shit, different shit, and I just wanted to work. So I don't even care if it, like, if we do it or not, but it's just giving you the idea to, you know, push what you got going on and shit like that. So I want to see other people be better and shit like that. Ain't no hate and shit, none of that.
Facts.
I think the biggest problem is we ward each other shit down too much. You know what I'm saying? It's like you got a podcast, right? A nigga be more worried about who's listening to your shit versus, like, just get the fuck on the show. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, just get the fuck on the platform. Who's wearing it? Or who's, you know what I'm saying? Or who do you play for? Or what do you, you know what I'm saying? Like, facts. Just network, nigga. You know I'm doing something. We in the same room for a reason. 9 times out of 10, like, but you know, it is what it is.
Nah, but DMV culture, I feel like, you know, we're on a good track. We just, as like both of them said, we just got to come together. And then we actually have something in stores in a couple of months. We about to have this little convention. We about to link up with DMV Men and Media and a couple other media outlets. So stay tuned on our page. going to be featuring a lot of people in the city. So, you know, that's the kind of stuff that we want to do. And, you know, for collaborations, definitely hit up JO Iyce if you ever want to collab with him. Same with Damar and Frienemies, and same with MO. We all about collabing, and that's what this podcast is for, and that's why I started the media platform. So definitely, you know, we're trying to push the culture, and we're gonna keep it going. I'll let y'all do y'all shout-outs, you know, wrap up, you know, whatever y'all want to kind of say and give, you know.
I just want to do a fit check. That's all I want to do.
Wait, I don't know.
I'm going to get up for the camera. I'm going to get up for the camera so y'all can do a fit check.
Wait, shout out, and we didn't shout out that shirt because
I know this shit going down right now. Yeah. We got the friendly jeans on. You see, pussy is not motion. Hold on, let me turn it to the back. Pussy is not motion, and it is a lot of frenemies. So y'all come shop, man. We put the Instagram on a video.
What's the website so that people know? What's
Instagram. The website? Oh, Instagram. We gonna drop the website. We got a store coming too. So
okay, dope.
Instagram.
Instagram is a nigga's way out of a lot of shit, boy. You ain't gotta have a website. Nah, you ain't gotta have a business card. Your whole resume is on your page. Like,
can do call,
like, hey, you got a card on you? Hey, go to my Instagram page. I just DM you my number. Like,
nah, facts. That's true. Instagram was a dope invention. How about you, JO Iyce? We got any shout outs? Any where people can check you out?
Shout out to you for, you know, bringing me on the platform.
Definitely,
man.
Shout out to you.
You're right,
and
know,
I mean, shout out to the universe, man. Shout out to everybody who's working and supporting other people that's working. Cause as long as I've been in this, I can't even count how many people I put in position in so many different lanes just because I could fucking do it. It wasn't even no motive behind it. It was just because I had the ability to do it. And there's no hate in my blood. And I feel like the more people I could build up, the more resources I'm going to have later on, too.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So shout out to y'all. Everybody else, you know, it is what it is. You know.
Y'all got any upcoming projects that y'all want people to peep?
I got some coming up with live mixtapes. It's pretty big. I can't announce that yet. But about 2 weeks, check live mixtapes. It'll be at the top banner.
I want an exclusive on that.
Yeah, it's going to be something nice.
How about you, Damar?
I wanted to make one more shout-out. Shout-out to the people that's, you know, if you got dreams and you feel like you can't accomplish it or you want to give up, man, keep pushing. That shit going to be all right, and you're going to get it. Don't lock in with your dream. Don't let nobody tell you can't do nothing. Do that shit.
Big facts. And then shout-out, you just dropped some new stuff last week,
right?
Yeah,
I just dropped some merch. I'm about to drop some more merch. I put that on a video, too. So you can get on my Instagram. It's friends with a Z, 3 8s and an underscore, man. You can DM me. You can check out my page. Just check out my page and tell me how you like it. That's support to me. You ain't got to buy nothing. But if you see something you like, definitely DM me.
Big facts. Well, first of all, I want to say, you know, last of all, I mean, appreciate y'all. I want to give y'all flowers. Keep what y'all doing. You know, JO Iyce, you a dope DJ. Every time you work with us, you know, you be having it popping.
Them niggas still mad at me over there. I don't know why. But it's okay. It's okay. We didn't address that shit, but it's okay.
JO Iyce still one of the best DJs, in my opinion. You know what I'm saying? If it was up to me, you'd be there every time. But shout out to Damar, dope ass clothing brand. Shout out to our video offer, Y'all Images. Y'all can check him out. I'll have his information on the bottom too. So if y'all want to do any video production, podcast, he does all of that. So shout out to him as well too. And shout out to y'all for you know, checking us out and always supporting us. This is Abel, and we tuning out.
Let's go. Appreciate it. All right, this is Damar with MO Boombox. Make sure y'all come and tap in.
You already know what it is. Your boy DJ JO Iyce, Freeband Gang. You know the vibes. Make sure you tap in with MO Boombox. We outside, baby.
Yeah. So bad. Instead, let me know you kept secrets. But if I cut you this deep, you'd be in pieces. You'd be in pieces. Even if I did, you would be the last up on that list. I still can't believe you did that shit. To forgive, came in terms that we may never get back to what we used to be.